helplessness, and you deviate from the path. And once you get off the path, it's not that the problems are coming at you and you can't see clearly that it's going to keep you from winning. It's you getting off the path because you can't see clear and you deviate from the course, and then you run smack into a destruction.
Yeah, kind of like the Israelites.
Does that make sense?
That's really good.
So stay focused in the vision, in the desire, in the breakthrough, and everything comes at you, and it's all a facade. And usually, as you stay focused and don't deviate, and you just keep pressing, and you keep pressing, and I mean, if all you can do is just wave a little pinky, just keep waving the pinky, because you're going to get through it.
Yes.
But the enemy wants to convince you that there is no end in sight of these attacks, and you jump ship. Right. Poof. And you go back to the tyranny of the familiar, because it's easier to deal with the pain of the past than it is to the unknown of the future and actually have breakthrough and live in that area.
That's so true.
Yes, it's easier for me to go back and say, hey, I liked it better than with the leeks and garlics in Egypt. At least I had leeks and garlics.
Yeah.
But now I got to trust in the God I can't see to provide manna from heaven and quail and water from a rock. This is an uncomfortable place.
Yes, amen.
How? Yes.